Rush 6, Valley 4 as we head to the fourth inning. The Bay Diggers will send up the top of the order. Gregory Maris, Hazel Scott, and Christian Baez. As the Bay Diggers batted around in the third. But Valley countered with seven hitters in the bottom of the third. The left-hander, Justin Hill, winds and delivers. And the breaking ball is grounded to short. Should be an easy play for DeRoot. Throw to first, and Maris is retired for the first out of the fourth inning.
Maris grounds out to the shortstop for the first out. Brings up number six, Jesus Cardenas.
Jesus popped to right and struck out looking. He's 0 for 2. And that could also be the difference in this game, which pitcher settles down. Hirschfeld got out of a nice jam after allowing a two-run double by retiring two hitters in a row on ground balls to Maris. And the wind by Jesus, the wind in the pitch to Cardenas is in the dirt. One ball, no strikes. Six runs on seven hits for Brush. Valley with four runs on six hits. Both teams have committed two errors. Bay Diggers have stranded three. Valley has stranded five. Huntington gets the sign from the dugout, lays it down. And the one ball, no strike pitch is a changeup for a strike at the knees. Count is level at 1-1. Jesus ready. And the 1-1 pitch swung on and lined into left field. That's the eighth hit of the game for the Bay Diggers. Jesus is now 1-for-3. That'll bring up Christian Baez.
Number 8, Christian Baez.
Who is grounded to short. Check that, grounded to second and grounded to third. He's 0-for-2. Every Bay Digger but Baez and Blake have been on base. Let's see if Christian can change that, or at least half of that. Jesus got to watch out over there. He's got a big lead at first against the lefty, and the breaking ball is a beauty for a strike. It's 0-1. Baez has been very, very good in center field since moving over there from left. Awaits the 0-1 pitch. That changeup is in the dirt. One ball, one strike. Your one-stop shop for all of your banking and investment needs, from checking to savings to IRAs, is Morgan Federal Bank. 321 Ensign Street, Morgan Federal Bank. There's a difference. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender. 6-4. Brush leads Valley in the fourth. One on, one out. And the 1-1 and the throw to first. And back in diving is Jesus Cardenas. Again, a big, big alley out in right center. Game time, exactly 1 hour. We started at 3:54. Throw to first, back in diving. Is Cardenas once again. The big inning for the Bay Diggers was the five-run third. They also scored a run in the second. And the pitch, and that's a strike. Took something off of that one. It's 1-2. At the knees on the inner half. To the Bay Diggers center fielder. Baez is a little bit closer to that plate. He'll shorten up the swing on the one ball, two strike pitch. Here it is. Breaking ball is lined towards right field. That's a base hit. Jesus is going to step on second and stay right there. And the Bay Diggers have now have nine hits in the game.
Brings up number 15, Shea Hansen.
A good pitch thrown by Hill, but Baez kept his eye on the ball. He went down and got that one. Here's Shea Hansen, who struck out looking and then smoked an RBI double into the right center field gap. The stretch by Hill. The look back, the pitch, changeup in the dirt. I mean, if Huntington doesn't stop some of these balls, it'd be about three or four wild pitches. He's doing a great job behind the plate for Valley. Runners take their leads. And the 1-0. Swag. They're missing a ball up in the zone. And the count is level at 1-1 to Shea Hansen. The Bay Diggers played a 2.5-hour game against Meade in Longmont on Tuesday. In the top of the fourth inning, there were more throws to first base than to the plate. And that contributed to the length of that game. The pitch, breaking ball swung on and lifted to center field. And that ball is going to land for a base hit in front of Nunez, one base at a time, as Hansen hit it off the end of the bat, and the bases are loaded for Colby Wehlert. and Nunez started back. You can't blame him, considering how these balls have been flying out. Rush now has 10 hits in the game. Cardenas to third, Baez to second, Hanson at first, and Weidert has a double and a two-run homer. He has loved hitting here so far. The Beatniggers have led by as many as four, looking to break it open here. Wind and pitch, and the fastball tails outside. One ball and no strikes. Hanson now at 2-for-3. This lineup is getting very dangerous for the Beatniggers between the meat of the order and even some of the other players delivering clutch hits. 1-0, breaking ball is hit foul on the ground up the third base side. 1-1, that's the pitch I think that Hill wants to establish against Weidert, because the changeup and fastball have been hit towards the center field fence, including that two-run homer I just alluded to in the third inning. And the 1-1, and the changeup is in the dirt again. Ball two, strike one to the Beatniggers shortstop. Rush leads Valley 6-4. We're in the top of the fourth inning from the Field of Dreams here at Bigfoot Turf Farm in LaSalle. 2-1. And that's a strike. Took something off of that on the outside half at the knees. It's 2-2. 2-2 to Weidert with Tormolin on deck. Wind and pitch. Curveball is chopped foul up the third base side towards the Digger dugout. Count remains at 3-2. And Hill is approaching the 70 pitch mark. He had 55 through 3 unofficially. A big, big hitter for Justin Hill right now if he wants to stay on the hill. 2-2. Swung on and fouled off to the right on a ball that jammed Weidert. Count stays at 2-2 to the Beatnigger shortstop. At third is Cardenas. Baez at second. Hanson at first. They all singled. As Weidert awaits the pitch, and the breaking ball is in the dirt. 3-2. This will be the eighth pitch of the plate appearance for Weidert. Runners take their leads. Out of the windup is Hill. And here's the pitch, and the curveball is low. Boy, Weidert took a pitch that was all over the strike zone, but it dropped low. He walks. It's his third RBI as Jesus Cardenas scores, and the Beatniggers now lead 7-4, and the bases are reloaded for Mitch Tormolin. Boy, you talk about discipline. Weidert saw that ball beautifully out of Justin Hill's hand. Mitch Tormolin popped the center and walked the pitch. Curveball is grounded foul up the third base side. It's 0-1. I mean, that was a pitch that Weidert had to think about, but that tells you how well he's seeing the ball. I'm telling you, that pitch was not out of the strike zone by much, but it was definitely a ball. Boy, thank goodness for the press box for us, because this is getting to be unbearable just looking at it out there. One ball and no strikes with the bases loaded. One in, one out. The pitch swung on and grounded up the middle. Could be two. DeRue, the shortstop, bobbles the ball, and everybody's going to be safe. As he went to his left, he had to play at second if he came up with it cleanly, and the Beatniggers now lead 8-4. Baez scores. Well, I think we'll probably score that a base hit only because he was lunging to his left. We'll give Tormolin the base hit and the RBI only because it was, again, hit to DeRue's left, and Justin Hill is going to leave the game. We'll take a break and come back with a pitching change after this. Brush 8, Valley 4 in the top of the fourth inning on 1010 KSIR and KSIR.com. The Beatniggers have picked up four hits and two runs in the inning. They lead Valley 8-4 with one out. The bases loaded. Logan Wilson, the right-hander, is the new pitcher. Justin Hill goes to center field, which means Edgar Nunez is out of the game. And Ken Garcia will be the hitter, the seventh hitter of the inning. The Beatniggers batted around in the third. Garcia reached on an error and had an RBI single in the third inning. So he is 1-for-2. And a tough task here for Logan Wilson to keep his team in the game, trailing by four runs and with the Beatniggers threatening. For great family entertainment, walk in or reserve your time in Lane at Fire Lanes, 220 Cambridge, in Brush. At third is Hanson, second is Waiter, Tormolin at first. One out in the fourth. And the pitch, and the breaking ball's on the outside corner for a strike. It is 0-1 to the beat digger first baseman, Ken Garcia. The wind in the 0-1, swung on, that ball is chopped on the right side. Dellenbach, the first baseman, is going to come home for the out, and then the throw to first, and that is going to be late. So they get the out at home. That'll go 3-2. The bases are reloaded with two down for Coyote Cohen.
Garcia reaches on the fielder's choice. Hanson out, free to go.
So Wehlert is now at third, Tormolin at second, and Garcia at first. Cohen struck out looking, and then tripled in a run in the third. So this is a big hitter for both teams. The pitch, the fastball's a strike. On the outer half of the knees, it's 0-1. Runners take their leads. Wilson out of the windup. And the 0-1 pitch, the breaking ball is low. One ball and one strike. The wind and the 1-1 pitch, swung on, chop, foul, right at the plate. 1-2. Hill is still responsible for the men at second and third. He threw 76 pitches and allowed 8 runs on 11 hits. Will he allow another 2 if Cohen delivers? He's down in the count. The pitch, swing and a miss and a ball in the dirt, and the catcher, Huntington, steps on the plate to get the out, and the inning is over. The beat diggers do score 2 runs, and they do it on 4 base hits, no errors, and the bases were left loaded. The beat diggers have stranded 6-4. Let's head to the bottom of the 4th inning. It's Brush 8, Valley 4 on 1010 KSIR and KSIR.com.